So, Kim Yong-jun and Professor Lu and all other advisor or the advisor organizer, and I visited Korea almost every year. But I was told before that the KAIST is the one of the best universities in Korea, also in the world, and so I'm happy to have a chance to visit here. Today my talk is spreading influence of the invasive species and disease. Spreading influence was described by the free boundary. I'm Lin from Yangtze University. Let's first see the what is free boundary. Usually, in mathematics, many phenomena was represented by the differential equations, which are defined in a domain. Usually, the domain is a fixed domain. If the domain is unknowing, have to be determined together with the solution, not only solution, but also the boundary, then this problem is called a free boundary problem, and the boundary is called the free boundary. Let's see the classical model. This is from the classical example is the Stefan problem around 100 years before, and which traces the formation of the ice in the polar seas. The boundary between water and ice is moving with time. And if you see the, if here is the water, it's ice, or we can also ice and with water. And as time, as the temperature changes, the boundary is changing. So we have this kind of, the boundary is changing as T goes to, as T changes. And this is the one-dimensional case. And there are many types of free boundary problem. For example, tumor growth. Tumor growth, the surface of the tumor growth is described by the free boundary, the tumor change. And it, the tumor, so it, if the if it, it, it becomes small, it's good. There are many researchers, for example, Freedom Man, for example, Chen. And also another model is for the option, European-American option. The option, we know the optimal exercise boundary, this is changing. We don't know. We don't know at the beginning, we don't know the boundary. And its boundary is between the stopping range and stopping range and the continued range. Now there are many researchers in this area. My advisor, the Professor Jiang, and also famous younger Professor Deng has also studied this kind of works, and these are two types free boundary problem. Now there are many researchers are doing this kind of things. Okay, let's see the invention. We have two examples. One is the classical one. The classical example of the invention is a special spreading of spread of masquerades. This is a masquerade. The masquerades, which is special native to North America, was brought to Europe for fur breeding at the old time, 100 years ago. Fur is very expensive, so they want to use this masquerade, use this fur. And in 1895, five masquerades escaped from a farmer. The farmer is near Prague. And they started to spread and reproduce. Now it's inhabiting the entire European continent. In the period of 50 years, this five masquerades and then escaped, then reproduced, then inhabited the entire Europe. Today, its number, meanings, and the habitat is expanding, and the frontier can be described as a free boundary. We can see the from this map. You can see the in 1905 and also 1909 and something like this. They found the masquerade spread. Well, this Scullum in 1951, he calculated the area, for example, if the spread the masquerade to expand to this area, it is not a ball, but he calculated the area. S T depends on T. For example, in this year, in 1905, in 1909, and also here is 1915, and he calculated the area, and then he took his square. It's equals to 2π square π t. He found that this is the time, and then this square is almost near the linear line. It's the line. He found that the data points lay out the straight line. The square root of the area increased linearly with time. This is almost a 9. It means that the spreading of the masquerade follows a linear fashion. It means that the spreading rate is a constant. Also, we have another example. Is the spreading of Canitos in Australia. I think Australia have two big problems. One problem is a big fire because the weather is drying. And also another thing is the invasive species because the Canitos was introduced to Australia from Hawaii in June 1935 as a method of agricultural pest control. Use this masquerade Canitos to control the pest. This toad has no natural predators in Australia, and they are bred very well. They have become a destructive addition to the natural Australia habitat. This Canitos now is now they become a pest and invasive species because you know toxic skin is harmful to animals. So this is a big problem in Australia. The Canitos spread to quickly. By August 1935, more than 202 young toads was released in Queensland. The northern Queensland And release was temporarily limited because they don't know what will happen. So limited when small part. Since they are released, toads has rapidly multiplied in population, and no number over 200 million. This is the similar as that population of Australia. Toads has steadily expanded their range through Queensland, reaching the bound in New South Wales in 1978, and the northern part in 1984. And the important thing is that there is the estimate the canny toads migrate at an average of 40 kilometers per year. Each year they migrate 40 kilometers. Let's see our model. This is a joint work with Professor Yi Hong Du. And before this model, I should explain some classical one. The first one is the given by Stephen in 100 years ago. And the model is to describe the water and rice. Ice, you see, if there is water, this is ice. And the equation is the heat equation. This is zero. And this fixed boundary use the U zero T equals to FT. And he assumes that FT goes to one. And the boundary on the free boundary, this is the moving boundary. U is equal to zero because this water and ice, and this is H zero. He found that if the FT goes to one as T to infinity, and the solution U goes to one, and this free boundary x equal to ht over square t goes to a constant, for example, is k. This is the classic one. And if the equation is Fujita equation, we use the ut minus now plus u is up. P is greater than 1, greater than 1, we have this free boundary. This boundary is use the Neumann boundary condition, so that we can also have this boundary. We can have the symmetrical left part. And for this equation, they have some different result. For example, we have the blow-up solution. Blow-up solution and also faster solution. And also slow solution. What is blow-up? It means that as there is a time t, zero, and t goes to t, zero, then u goes to infinity. So the solution blows up at the finite time. What is the faster solution? It means that the solution this way. The free boundary is limited. They cannot to be finite. And the solution goes to zero. This is the fast solution. Also, there is a slow solution. Slow solution means that the free boundary is not limited. It goes to infinity. And the solution goes to zero. So we have the three different solutions. And now we still don't know this case, slow solution is the whether or not it is Euclides. We will talk later if I have time. Now we come back to our model. The model is right in this way. This is the logistic equation. And we has the Neumann boundary condition on the fixed boundary, on the left fixed boundary. You can also have this kind of the same left boundary, free boundary. For this model, we know this system models the spreading of the new or invasive spatial with population density U over one dimensional habitat. Here the boundary, the free boundary represent the spreading front. A is the intrinsic growth rate of the spatials. B is the intraspatial accommodation, and D is the dispersal rate. This has been I'm explained before by many researchers talks, and this work seems the first attempt to use the condition in the study of the spreading of the population. And now we have no time to explain how to get this free boundary. If you are interested in it, I can show you later. What is the result? You know, for the heat equation, we have this kind of result, the U goes to 1. For the Fujita's equation, we have this kind of blow-up solution, fast solution, slow solution. What is about this? U, for the asymptotical stable, and then what is the result? And also, what is the behavior of the HT, the free boundary? In our model, for the Stefan condition, Stefan problem, and HT is increased. So it must has the limit, the H infinity. What is the infinity? H infinity. This is what I want to give. So we have this result. We have the spreading and vanishing dichotomy. It means that we have two choices. One choice is spreading. HT goes to infinity, and U goes to a constant A over B. A over B is the positive equilibrium. And another is the vanishing. HT is limited, and U goes to zero. So we have two choices. One is U goes to a constant A over B, and this H infinity is infinity. And also another one is U goes to zero, H phi is finite. And also we have here, the H infinity less than this number. And this result shows that the spreading vanishing dichotomy occurred for the logistic model. Namely, as T goes to infinity, the population either successfully established itself, because the U goes to A over B is a constant. we call the spreading. And also, they are spread the whole area, the HT goes to infinity. And all, another result is the vanishing. It means that the population fails to establish and vanish eventually. It disappear. In the long run, it disappear. This is the result. And we have two choices. When the first spreading happens, when the vanishing happens, so we next decided when each of these two occurs, we have this kind of result. If H0 is bigger, then spreading happens. If the initial occupied area is bigger, H0 is bigger, if the initial occupied area is bigger, then spreading should happens. If the H0 is small, then spreading or vanishing happens depends on mu star. Mu star, what is the mu star? Mu star is the parameter on the Stefan condition. This is the number. These parameters measure the ability to the new area. The ability to new area. So if the ability is strong, he can move. He can move quickly, like Canitos in Canada, or Masquerade in Europe. The criteria of for spreading or vanishing are the following. If the initial occupied is beyond the critical size, if this is a critical size, and then regardless of initial population, no matter what how many animals or how many canitos there are, spreading always happen. Otherwise, if H0 is small, whether spreading or vanishing happen depend on the initial size and the coefficient mu in the Stefan condition. And when we got this result, we are thinking about this kind of a similar result like this. We consider this kind of result, similar result. But we find this, we cannot get this result. This is Stefan given 100 years ago. And we found that the HT over T goes to constant. Professor Yi Hong and me, we found that this is right, HT over, this is not that. You see, we found that HT over T goes they have the limit as time goes to infinity. This is a constant. Actually, at that time we don't know this result, and we found this is a constant. The limit is a constant. Then we think we should have some support. So Professor Yi Hong and me to look for the reference, and we check the two examples I've given before, and we found that there's some evidence to show that the spreading speed is a constant. So we found that this interesting is this is constant, and we have submitted and accept the paper has submitted. Then Professor Yi Hong asked his two colleagues to give the simulation because they are familiar with this simulation, and they found a stranger. This number, the K0, cannot be bigger. No matter what you change the parameters, other parameters, still this K0 cannot be bigger. Then we check the our proof, we check out the proof, we found we neglect, we have the result. K0 between, is from 0 to 2 times square A times D. And this number is very important. And also we found the K0 is increase in U, mu and A. Mu is the ability to a new area. A is the litter, is the birth rate minus death rate. B is the intra-spatial computation. And, but it doesn't depend on D in a monotone fashion. It, the, as D is small or D is bigger, then the K0 is small. But there should be have some maximal result at the value in the middle. Okay, let's see. Comparison with other theoretical result. As we know, this Lochester equation in the Cauchy problem is the whole area from infinity minus infinity to infinity. We have the classical work from Fisher and Kolmogorov in 1937. They gave the traveling wave solution. Traveling wave solution has been found for this model, for the Cauchy problem. For any C is greater than or equal to C minimal. C minimal is equal to this number we have given before. And if C is bigger, then there is the traveling wave solution. If C is small, there is no solution. But here, we have solution. So C, if C is small, we have the free boundary. So we think maybe the traveling wave solution is the limit case of our free boundary problem. Because our problem free boundary K0 is from K0 goes from 0 and the C minimal is the C greater than or equal to C minimum or is equal to, there is no solution, but we have the solution, free boundary problem, we have the solution. And also, there is another speed, it's called the spreading speed of the new population U. It's given by the Allison and Weinberg. They have the, another defined the C star. C star is the spreading speed. It means that if the rat is less than C star, U goes to A over B. If the rat X over T is greater than C star, then U goes to zero. So they call this speed is the spreading speed. Our result is K0. I show that. And they found that the C minimal is equal to C star for the Lochester equation, for Lochester model. I don't know this result whether or not this result holds for other models. It means that the K0, our the free boundary problem, is always less than C minimum. C minimum is also is always equal to C star. But for this result, still have for the system reaction diffusion system, this result still don't know. And we hope it's hold for all the other models. Our model and with the Cauchy problem, there's some difference. First, we have the spreading front. This front is given by the x equal to ht, we have this function to describe the front. And another one is for the Cauchy problem, it means that it always succeeds for the spreading. It always happen. For any long trivial initial population, it always happens the spreading. But we have the spreading or vanishing. It means that not all the imaginary spatial can establish. Maybe it disappear or distinguished in the future. But in the second model, the Cauchy problem, they are always established. Then also we have the spreading speed. This speed is depend on all the parameters. You see, this spreading speed is only depend on A and D, independent of B, and this is increasing with D. But we have the asymptotical spreading speed depends on all the parameters. Also, we have some comparison with experimental result. This experimental result is given. You can see the book in 2007. There is the experiment on insect biocontrol in New Zealand, reported in this journal. And this field experiment was used to manipulate the critical first stage of the inversive of this special this insect in New Zealand to observe the progress of the invention over the four years to give the experiment. You see this peace lease was used to control the bloom. It was used to control the bloom. And how to give this experiment? They use 135 kilogram long. 135 long. They are put 55 place. 55 the place and gave the peace lease. And 10 place put 2. 10 place put 2. The 10 place put 2. And 10 place put 4. 3. And also 4. 10 place for 10. And also 5 place put 270. And then they check the still there is the, this insect and they found 6 years later they found 22 place size still have this insect. It means that 22 spread and others 23 disappear. Also, we have the number. We find that only two pieces still successful. We 6 years later, they have more than 300. Also, this for released 4 pieces, and also you can see this is five place to put the 270 there. If the initial data is bigger, then it's easy to the spread. There's some result about this. This is a logistic model for our free boundary problem. And recently, Yihong and me and have the computation model, immersive of competitor in a computation model. You know, we know the computation model in bounded domain has been discussed by many researchers. The following result is we are knowing R0 is 0, 0 is always unstable. It's unstable. And if A1 over A2 is between these two numbers, then R star is a positive equilibrium. This global asymptotically stable. In this case, it's called a weaker computation case because the commutators coexist in the long run. In the long run, this is the first case. And the second case is if A1 over A2 is is bigger, then R1 is A1 over B1 is 0 is the global asymptotically stable. As that, in this case, U wipes V out and U wins. So U is superior commutator. And similarly, we have U is the inferior commutator. If A1 over A2 is small, I don't know which case is congruent speed to U B times C less than 1. You have talked yesterday. I don't know. Maybe we don't know have these parameters. We missed simplified this number later in the future. If B1 or if A1 or A2 is between these two, then this is very complicated. And R1 and R2 are locally asymptotically stable, and R star is unstable. It's not easy to determine. And we consider the free boundary. And here you see the R is from 0 to HT. It means that U is the inversive, invariant. V is a relative special from 0 to infinity. They always have this kind of special. Then we have the free boundary, is Stefan condition. We have the result. If A1 over A2 is small. In this case, called the invariant is inferior. In this case, we have the U goes to 0, V goes to A2 over C2 in compact subset. This is similar as that of in the fixed boundary. This result, inferior case. The invariant cannot establish itself, and the relative special always survives the invention. It's similar as that in fixed domain. The problem with the in the fixed domain is similar. If the invariant is superior, it means that A1 over A2 is bigger. In this case, it's different. We have the spreading or vanishing. Spreading means that U wins and V goes to 0. Relative special disappear, extinguished. And then the U expanded to all area. And vanishing is the U goes to U. Even the U is strong, is superior, but still the disappear. In this case, still vanishing. We have this two choice. Now let's to the SIS model in a special heterogeneous environment. Yeah, I read the paper by Alan Walker and Lou and Larry. And I found that it's very interesting. They have some interesting thing, they gave the deflation the low risk and a higher risk. So I found it's very interesting. If beta and gamma, you know, the beta is the disease consummation. Usually we call it the contact rate. Gamma is gamma is a recover, disease recover. Gamma is called a recall rate. S is susceptible, I is infectable. This is the SIS model. And if the average of beta over omega is less than gamma, is that of gamma, it means that the contact rate is small and recall rate is bigger. It's easy to recover, so there is in this case is a low risk. Otherwise, we call the higher risk. Then they have the basic reproducible number R zero. I use the aim to determine denote the Lohmann boundary condition. We have this kind of basic reproduction number. Then they have some interesting result. The global stability of the disease-free equilibrium, the existence and uniqueness of positive endemic state, and also the asymptotical profile of the endemic state, as the diffusion coefficient for susceptible individuals is sufficiently small. There are some interesting result. Also, their result has been extended by Peng, Liu, and Peng. There are several works. Why I mention this model? Because I think the no matter what is a Lohmann boundary condition or Dirichlet boundary condition, we found that even the initial data is non-negative, non-trivial, even there is a little the infected, then the solution is always positive. It means that the disease spread to the whole area immediately, even infectious is limited as a small part at the beginning. You will see for the reaction diffusion system, if the initial data is non-negative, non-trivial, then the U always positive inside. It means that the disease spread to the whole area. It doesn't match the observation. We think the disease spread gradually. How to describe the disease if the infectious are initially limited in a special part? I use this. This part is infected. We have recovered. The whole part is we have the susceptible. So we have this SIS model with free boundary. And I use this total number. And this is infected. Infected is limited in this area from 0 to HT. Because we have no enough time, I just beyond the free boundary, there is only susceptible, no infectious individual. The free boundary represents the spreading front. We have the result. We say the disease is vanishing if H infinity less than infinity. Its infinity is finite, and infected disappear. If the the infection is only limited, it's only small part, and infected individual goes to zero. It means that is the disease is vanishing. Otherwise, if infinity is finite, is infinity, then and also they still have infectious. Then we call this spreading. We introduce the basic reproductive number zero. F denotes the free boundary. Zero T. We have the T. Usually the basic reproduction number given before is always constant. We first give the this kind of reproduction number depends on T, because you know the as time to change, then our area is from G T free boundary X is equal to G T X the right is H T. As time to change, this area, this interval is changing. Then from here we give the deflation. We found that this number is dependent on T. And then professor in Canada, Zhu and told me, and some researchers say that if the basic reproductive number is always constant, it's not good. It's a lot of or it's it should be depend on some T like this. So we give this new deflation. We find that this depends on beta and gamma. If the beta is the contacted rate, gamma is the recall rate, and also D is the diffusion rate. We find if R0F is is strictly monotone increase function of T. As T goes to as T bigger, then this number is bigger. And also if HT goes to infinity, then R0F goes to this number. And if beta gamma is a constant, it's just R0. So we connected the R0. R0F goes to R0. The R0 is given, usually given by the corresponding ordinary differential equation. They give this kind of number. Now we have this relation between these two reproductive number. And if R0FT greater than 1 for some time, if this is greater than 1, then spreading happens. If this for some times, if it goes for go some time T0, at that time the R0F greater than 1, then spreading happens. Then it means that the disease cannot control. And if R0F is less than 1, whether the disease is vanishing or spreading depends on the initial value of the infectious. We have the sharper threshold, and this result is similar as that given yesterday by Low. And here we have this, our model is for the SIS model. Suppose that beta gamma, beta R is greater than gamma R. If there is one point satisfies this beta greater than gamma, it means that if there is at least one point is high in risk, then we have this with this initial data R0 is sigma phi is given, then we have the threshold sigma star spreading such that spreading happens for bigger sigma and variation happens for small. It means that if the initial size is bigger, we cannot control the infection. Otherwise, we can control. And the disease is spread if the initial infected domain is larger. If the domain is larger, then R0F is always greater than 1. This spread is always happen. Or all size of initial domain are higher risk. The local disease transmission beta is higher. The disease is vanishing if the initial infected value is small. At the beginning, the infection is small and the disease, the domain is low risk. If it is higher risk, we still cannot control. And also I found the larger diffusion rate of the infected population benefit the invention of the disease. This I cannot understand. You know, we hope the infected population, you don't move, you stay there, you stay hospital, so that we can control. But here, the larger diffusion rate benefit the invention. Yeah, you know, the Professor Yuan Rong says slow diffusion win. Slow diffusion rate. But here, the larger, this also the slow diffusion win, but we don't want it to win. We want to it disappear. So larger diffusion rate of the infected population benefit the vanish of the disease. So I don't know how to explain because the it
you have boundary condition at the free boundary.
Yes.
So if you have a larger diffusion rate, that means you are losing more at the boundary. So that's reasonable.
Yeah. So maybe we change the free boundary, the condition.
Yeah.
That's the way. Yeah. This is the. Yeah. The on the boundary there's zero. So if they go faster, they are losing quickly.
That's fine.
But it doesn't match the fact. Okay, I have some related work, and this I gave nonlinearity 2007. Here in this paper, I gave the Stephen condition. The classical the Stephen condition was given by Stephen, but here I gave for the special. And I found that the two researchers and for our model, they gave the numerical analysis. And then to 2010, Yi Hongtu and me have the spreading vanishing dichotomy in diffusion logistic model with free boundary. And this, we just gave the spreading speed. Is a constant. We didn't give this result. It's less than 2 times square AD. Then we have also modify the result. The spreading speed is less than traveling speed in 2013. And Du and Guo extend our result to the radical case, and also. Because we have not enough time, so just mention it. Lo and also have some works. These are recent work, and also Professor An and me have now have the main environment, main epidemic model, and also the Yoshi Han told me he interested in the SIS model, and also my student. Now is doing this kind of free boundary problem. Okay, that's all. Thanks.
Any questions?
Just.